think I figured it out. Tell me if this makes sense. I am somebody that likes to post about my life on Facebook. I have friends and I have family who I consider to be friends and family that don't live nearby. And I would like to think that they are interested in my life and my growing family, in my accomplishments, in my struggles. I would like to think that they are there for me in a virtual reality. But I really don't know if they would be there for me in actual reality. So, we have an opportunity to post about the next step in my son's struggle. My son's struggle is that he is a little socially awkward. He's intense. He's got a mind that won't quit. He is very much like his mother and also very much like his father, which is obviously a toxic combination. He is also extremely smart and extremely talented. Another combination of his mother and his father. So not only does he have the best of us inside of him, he also has the worst of us. My husband is emotionally unavailable. I am emotionally intense. My son has both. Big time. So he is like, in my mind, he is awesome. But unfortunately, the world might have trouble understanding him, and he might have trouble understanding the world. When I knew this, when he was 4 and 5 years old, as a new mother, I'm overwhelmed. I'm not really sure what to make of it. I look to my husband for guidance. He's encouraging me to, yeah, let's go check it out, I guess. And they give us one answer. They give us the same answer again 2 years later. And we pretty much say, okay, I guess he's not autistic. I guess he's not on the spectrum. He just has some autistic-like behaviors, and doesn't have enough of them to be considered autistic. And unfortunately, that was all about the time that all of the DSM changed, where you don't have to be a specific number to be considered on the spectrum of autism. But they didn't grade him that way. They graded him for autism, actual autism. He didn't meet 9 markers or whatever. He only met 6 or 7. Well, now he's gone to the full gambit and he's met 7, which means he is on the spectrum. We can qualify for services for him, and this might be great news for us. I mean, I really do think it is, because we've been kind of like muddling along for the last 6 years or so of his life, not really sure how to help him. And he's doing his very best, and I don't really know how his future is going to look if we keep muddling like this. I really do think extra support and extra services is going to help him tremendously. So throughout this journey of trying to discover, does he have autism? Is he on the spectrum? Is it Asperger's? Is it not Asperger's anymore because the DSM doesn't recognize that anymore? Can he get services? Where do you get services for your autistic children? All of this information and questions I pose to my Facebook friends and family. And so when we finally get a doctor's office that will take my insurance and see him, evaluate him, spend tons of time researching not only him, but also the evaluation reports done by his teachers, staff, and parents, and they look at all his previous records and reports, they really did a thorough job, and they gave him autism spectrum disorder. So, what does that mean for us? I don't know. But I post this information up online. My step cousin doesn't approve. She thinks I'm violating his privacy. And of course, that opens up a whole new rabbit hole up here in this brain. And I start thinking, wow, how much of my child's privacy am I violating? By posting a photo of them, by laughing with them at something that's kind of funny, at posting something serious, at posting something embarrassing. I mean, why am I in charge of their online presence? Why can't they be in charge of it? When do they become in charge of it? Maybe I should let them have that option of when they become in charge of it, instead of forcing them to be online without their permission before they're even old enough to know that they're online. I kind of felt a huge amount of guilt for violating my children's privacy, not just because I posted the diagnostic codes that he was given, but because I post their photos, I post their videos, I post their cute little way of talking, even though it's not correct and it might sound like I'm making fun of them. I'm not. I love them, and I'm giving them their life online. I'm giving life to them online because I have friends and family who I would really like to know my children. Unfortunately, my children don't know my family. My children don't know my friends. So how much of it does it go? So I told you I figured it out, but then I didn't really tell you what I figured out. I think I figured out that my I went into that whole spiel and I have forgotten what I was going to say, because my mind goes right back to the rabbit hole and I don't know what I was thinking before when I was out of the rabbit hole. Now I'm right back in it and I'm feeling guilty again. So I'm going to go to work. I'm going to figure it out and then I'll let you know later. Bye.